Celebrate. Enable.
Located in the center of India, Madhya Pradesh is the second largest state, covering over 3 lakh square kilometers in area. It is bound by UP on the north and Chhattisgarh on the east, by Gujarat and Rajasthan on the west, and Maharashtra on the south. This also is the key advantage of Madhya Pradesh, as it occupies a pivotal position in the country and thus deservedly earns the moniker the Heart of India.
हमारे सभी अतिथिगण, बहनों और भाइयों, सबसे पहले मैं आप सबका मध्य प्रदेश की इस पवित्र धरती पर माँ अहिल्या देवी की इस नगरी में हृदय से स्वागत करता हूँ, अभिनंदन करता हूँ।
The immense advantage of its infrastructure, coupled with great investment opportunities, makes MP a destination of choice for investors from within and outside India. To mark this opportunity, that the government of Madhya Pradesh hosted the Global Investment Summit 2012 at Indore recently.
Madhya Pradesh, we consider ourselves as a state whose time has come. We feel that in today's India, our state has all the comparative advantage that anyone would like to look at before choosing a destination. We have a fantastic manpower base now. Our location has always been a strength. We have created a climate, both within the government and the society at large in Madhya Pradesh, where people are extremely friendly. The government has continued to become increasingly responsive to the needs of the industry. I think this is our biggest strength.
Some of the key advantages of MP as an investment destination include its proactive administrative setup, simple and transparent procedures for investment, peaceful industrial work atmosphere, rich natural resource base, educated and skilled human resource, a diversified agricultural and industrial setup, well-connected road, rail and air network, excellent telecommunication network, world-class shopping malls, and a large consumer base. Key advantages were highlighted at the Global Investor Summit, a three-day investor extravaganza that addressed major investors from the Indian business world. One of the key highlights of the summit this year was a special dedication to the micro, small and medium enterprises.
किसी भी राज्य में अर्थव्यवस्था अच्छी करने के लिए स्थानीय रोजगार, स्थानीय उद्योग ये बहुत ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि स्थानीय उद्योग स्थानीय रोजगार पैदा करता है और स्थानीय रोजगार ही मध्य प्रदेश किसी भी प्रदेश की अर्थव्यवस्था को मजबूत करने के लिए कारगर होता है।
There are over 4 lakh micro and small scale industries registered in MP, involving an investment of over 3,000 crores, which employs more than 12 lakh people. During the Global Summit, 113 MOUs were signed at the MSME Conclave, which involved investments to the tune of 670 crores. We'll bring you more such interesting highlights from the Global Investor Summit 2012 at Indore after a short break. The Global Investor Summit was a great opportunity for the state government of Madhya Pradesh to showcase its ample infrastructure in various sectors. Some of the major sectors that were highlighted at the summit from investment point of view were IT and ITES, renewable energy, textile, healthcare and pharmaceuticals, warehousing and logistics, urban development and auto engineering. The IT and ITES sectors of MP has made over 2 billion rupees worth software exports in 2011 and 12. 12 SEZs have been granted approval. Its existing parks are situated in Indore and Gwalior, and the ones proposed are to be set up in Bhopal, Indore and Jabalpur. The key advantages for setting up IT industry in MP include its existing industry base, availability of land, a talent pool, R&D facilities and a quality of life that is conducive for young professionals. The state has over 24,000 kilometers of optical fiber laid down up to block levels with 24/7 power supply via dedicated feeders, and the state claims to have at least 30% lower operational costs as compared to other states.
Madhya Pradesh has come a long way in terms of their progress and prosperity under the current Chief Minister. So it's good to showcase those achievements. More important, for many of us who have been looking at Madhya Pradesh, I mean, it's a reaffirmation of faith that, you know, this can be done. And as I was telling somebody, I mean, the opportunity for the IT sector to maybe build a $10 billion industry from Madhya Pradesh is very real. TCS's investment is probably the first trigger, and I'm sure we'll see many more companies coming and investing in Madhya Pradesh.
One of the key reasons for the growth of Madhya Pradesh has been its rapid industrialization over the last decade. From 394 towns in 2001, the state now has 476. The four major cities of Indore, Bhopal, Jabalpur and Gwalior houses a million plus population, acting as a catalyst in consumer-driven economic development. The state has ample opportunities in developing integrated townships, group housing, high-end apartments and villas, commercial, retail, hospitality and office spaces. A rapid industrialization coupled with a burgeoning agri sector and enhanced tourism makes room for growth and densification of cities. The urbanization is expected to gather further fillip with a metro rail project which is expected to come up in Indore and Bhopal with an investment to the tune of 18,000 crore rupees.
Madhya Pradesh has good governance. Madhya Pradesh has evolving high quality infrastructure, and Madhya Pradesh has good business climate. People are positive. Government is extremely firm, supportive and very clear. And I think these are factors which motivate business to invest in a state. I think MP is fast evolving into a state with a very good infrastructure, in spite of the fact that it is landlocked. The advantage for Madhya Pradesh is that it is within a few hours, 6 to 8 hours from ports. Madhya Pradesh to Bombay now by car is 8 hours. I think by truck also it can get to 8 hours or so, which is not a great deal.
The other most important and upcoming sector in Madhya Pradesh is the auto and engineering sector. While MP has clocked a growth of over 17% in manufacturing sector and 8% industrial growth during the fiscal of 2011 and 12, the auto sector witnessed a steady rise during the period, with the turnover of the auto sector amounting to over 3 lakh crores. Automotive exports too have grown at a CAGR of 24% and automotive production in the state at 13% during the financial years of 2006 to 11. The MP government is now all set to take its auto industry to the next level with major announcements and incentives to gather further investments.
Madhya Pradesh has a very progressive policies. The Chief Minister is very keen to industrialize the state. Our experience with our two-wheeler plant in Pithampur has been good. Availability of land and power is easier here. And I think these are some of the factors which are making us come here. The beauty of this place is that the manpower is very cross-cultural, good working, and I think industrial peace is good.
A significant area for investments in MP include the healthcare and pharmaceutical sector. The advantage MP has as a medical hub lies in its human capital, financial capital, medical facilities, vaccines and machines. The state has 50 district hospitals, over 1,000 primary health centers and over 8,000 sub-centers, over 300 community health centers, 28 Ayurvedic hospitals and one Yurami hospital.
Health, the state government's parameters were not very good vis-a-vis the national targets. So the state government has put a lot of investments and a lot of proactive policies to improve the health parameters. Health for all is a goal, and the state government has a proactive policy for providing affordable medical services and in many cases free medical services for the poor.
One of the major advantages of MP as an investment destination is its power generation. The state is now increasingly focused on renewable energy. The renewable energy sector constitutes of wind energy at 70%, solar energy at 2%, biomass at 9% and small hydro plants at 19%. The state government is now looking forward to attract investments in renewable and alternate energies in order to meet the power demands of the tribal and underdeveloped areas. There is ample support from the state government to support new investors in these sectors.
Power, as our Chief Minister stated this morning, and very proudly, we supply 24/7 power to industry. And once our feeder separation program is complete in 2013, not only all towns, all villages will get 24-hour supply. Agriculture will get assured supply. So we are comfortable on the power situation, and perhaps one of the best in the country today.
Textile has been one of the major advantages of the Madhya Pradesh government. A textile hub, MP's textile history goes back to the 19th century. Weaving, printing and dyeing of fabrics have an age-old tradition in MP. MP is the fourth largest cotton producer in India and produces 6% of the country's cotton yarn, with over 20 lakh bales produced every year. Number of textile mills in MP have increased now to 60. With a total installed capacity of spindles crossing over 15 lakh, textile exports from MP is estimated to about 18,000 crores per annum. The state government has enumerated huge benefits for future investors and new entrants in the textile sector.
Madhya Pradesh is the heart of India, and for Sri Lanka, it's a very important state. Already 250,000 Sri Lankans come every year to Madhya Pradesh Shanti. So we have substantial interest with Madhya Pradesh. And given that, and given the enormous potential available in this state, and the progress they have already made, and the kind of infrastructure facilities, the friendliness of the Chief Minister and his team, I am very confident some Sri Lankan investors would be looking at Madhya Pradesh, especially the apparel industry, where they are looking to invest abroad. They will find Madhya Pradesh as a very interesting destination.
The Madhya Pradesh Global Investor Summit witnessed a confluence of business and political leaders who were present to support and encourage present and future investors in the state. Here's a glimpse.
For India, states are a big focus. States are our future. It's the linking of the pearls or the string of pearls strategy for the country, where if each state is able to grow and flourish as a country, we can grow and flourish. And I think Madhya Pradesh has in no uncertain way shown the way on how to grow and how to grow smartly. With the right kind of inclusive growth and the right focus areas as a country.
That Madhya Pradesh is the most attractive investment destination in the country for the future. We believe that Madhya Pradesh today is the best success story of India. As an entrepreneur, I would like to applaud the state and in particular the Honorable Chief Minister for stewarding the state to become a great investment destination. His personal leadership, I believe, has gone a very long way to make this happen.
I'm honored to be here in Indore today at the Global Investors Summit of Madhya Pradesh, and we at CII are privileged to be the national partner of the government of Madhya Pradesh in an undertaking of such a vast scale.
ये प्रदेश बहुत तेजी से प्रगति की है, जैसे मैंने पहले कहा, निरंतर प्रगतिशील है और उत्पादकता के साथ है. प्रदेश के हित में नहीं, अपने हित में इस प्रदेश में सबको आना चाहिए.
There are over 2,500 people who have come here today and who are participating here. There are 1,900 people in this location here, and since the state could not accommodate most of them, another 600 people are sitting adjoining. This really signifies the mood, the attraction, the environment that the state of Madhya Pradesh is offering to each one of us.
Industrial growth देश से ज्यादा हमारी, हम 8% पे हैं अभी. डेयरी क्षेत्र में अभी सहारा जी ने कहा देश की ग्रोथ 12% हमारी 22% है, और आप जब आ जाएंगे तो पता नहीं कहां पहुंचेगी. इसलिए जिस तरीके से प्रदेश का विकास हो रहा है निश्चित रूप से, और माननीय अडवाणी जी जिस तरीके से हमने, ये बहुत बड़ा भौगोलिक क्षेत्र वाला प्रदेश, यहाँ आदिवासी हैं, ग्रामीण क्षेत्र है, अर्बन एरिया है, तीनों हैं.
मैं मानता हूँ कि कॉन्ट्रास्ट जो है सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का और यहाँ की मध्य प्रदेश की सरकार का, वह प्रमुख रूप से ये है कि हियर यू सी अ सिंसियरिटी टू गिव द पीपल गुड गवर्नेंस, गिव ऑल द सेक्शंस ऑफ सोसाइटी satisfaction that they are being ruled by a good honest government, and therefore it is ke mujhe is prakar ke pradesh mein aakar ke apne sahyogiyon ko acha shasan chalate hue, imandar shasan chalate hue, janata ke hit ke liye karyakram ki yojana ki lagatar kalpana karte hue innovative steps lete rehna, ye dekh karke bahut anand hota hai.
कौन कहता है कि भारत आगे नहीं बढ़ेगा? निश्चित तौर पर हिंदुस्तान भी आगे बढ़ेगा, और मध्य प्रदेश जैसा राज्य अपने देश को आगे बढ़ाने में अपनी तरफ से कोई कोर कसर नहीं छोड़ेगा. मैं मित्रों आप सबका एक बार फिर यहाँ हृदय से स्वागत करता हूँ, अभिनंदन करता हूँ, क्योंकि हम तो सब एक परिवार के सदस्य हैं. ये ग्लोबल की धारणा जो हमारी है, ग्लोबल समिट, लेकिन भारत का तो सोच ही ग्लोबल है. आज नहीं, हजारों साल पहले हमने कहा था, अयम निजम परावेत्ति गणना लघु चेत साम उदार चरिता नाम तू वसुदैव कुटुम्बकम. ये मेरा है, ये तेरा है, ये सोच छोटे मन वालों का होता है. जो विशाल हृदय के होते हैं वो तो कहते हैं सारी दुनिया ही एक परिवार है, सारी दुनिया को परिवार मानने की कल्पना हमारी है, और इसलिए ग्लोबल मित्र भी चिंता ना करें. ये भारत है जहाँ दुनिया में आज नहीं, हजारों साल पहले हम लोगों ने कहा धर्म की जय हो, अधर्म का नाश हो, प्राणियों में सद्भावना हो और विश्व का कल्याण हो.
With MOU signed between investors and the state government, recognition conferred on existing investors, and a blueprint laid out for the future course of action, the 3-day Global Investors Summit at Indore was yet another landmark in the economic history of Madhya Pradesh.